to sing a song about the moon. A little bit of a story behind this song. I was down visiting my family in Huntsville, Texas, and I had just come down from Alaska where I live. A friend asked me if I wanted to go over to Tomball, Texas, to the Tomball Cowboy Church.
There you go.
What is Cowboy Church? There wasn't a single thing when I left Texas.
Sorry, I don't have any.
So when I got over to Tomball, I was converted to hay barn. Bales of hay, saddle blankets, and pews. And I saw about 15 cowboys and cowgirls baptized in a horse water truck. Where was Cowboy Church when I was a young man living in Hillbent for 11, you know, but I really enjoyed going to that Tomball Cowboy Church. But on the way over, he put a tape in. He said, "Have you ever heard of Crystal Dude?" I said, "No." He said, "Well, here's the tape." And he played this song called the Blue Bonnet Blues. And I loved it, and I tried to learn it, so I'm going to do the best I can right now. And I thought of it tonight, it was because of that beautiful moon. There's a special place in my memory where I keep the pictures of the times and the places left far behind. And I know the years really have covered the ways it was back then. You know, I like to take the memories out, look at them from time to time. There's a full moon tonight on the prairie. A memory just floating again. A boy in a buckskin with an old family dog in the hill. Thank you.
leaves there, Jinx.
Did they lynch your people out, sir?
You said possible.
Oh, okay. Oh.
We're in PMD.
PMD.
Yes, sir. PMD.
I watched that show last night.
Marty Robbins song.
Marty Robbins.
Wonderful world are you? Well, I've seen the earth from a jet liner, and I've crossed an ocean or two. I've gambled and lost and stumbled across the wonderful world of you. I found the wonderful world of you. Miracles happen and daydreams come true. Now that I'm here, nothing else will do. A wonderful world of you. Well, I've been alone in a crowd of strangers. That was before I met you. Life was all wrong. I really belong in that wonderful world of you. I found the wonderful world of you. Daydreams to happen, daydreams come true. And now that I'm here, nothing else will do. The wonderful world of you. And turned all those gray skies to blue. You showed me new love, like skies from above. What a wonderful world of you. I found the wonderful world of you. Miracles happen and daydreams come true. Now that I'm here, nothing else will do. A wonderful world of you. It's a wonderful world of you.
Years, if I behave, Debbie can be convinced to come up and sing a song with me. This song was actually supposed to be played by me and Steve. We had a little gathering this afternoon, and I don't know how it worked out, but I get to sing it with my bride. And so it's kind of a tricky song. We've only run through it twice, so I may make a mistake. She'll be fine, I'm sure. So,
do I have to quieten down two or three of these drums?
Cut a couple of them off.
What key is this?
Well, we're going to decide that.
Okay.
Tempo change.
Oh, really? David?
Tempo changes. The other thing, it's December, and I've been playing Christmas music in December since I was in third grade, so that's pretty much what you're going to hear from me tonight. On the first day of Christmas my true love gave to me. A partridge in a pear tree.
Sir,
key G.
Oh. always, always.
Just.
Well, I was standing by my window. Oh, how long ago was my day?
Thank you.
I did, because I'm fun. Let's do something. Hey. Lost a lot of weight. This belt really doesn't work anymore. There's something in the back that's missing. The belt doesn't, my pant don't want to stay.
He started coming up here. I said, man, we need to learn from the examples. And so we were driving down the road one day down by the lake, and we come up on this curve, and there's this big sign right there, and it said loose gravel. And I thought, hey, that's a great name. Because it just says, well, we're not all that together, you know? So that's the story behind the loose gravel thing. Tonight's the debut, the first debut of the public of Loose Gravel.
So if you'd like to be a part of our little group, just let us know. We'll get you one of these shirts for $25.
Fan club. And the albums will be coming out soon. It's Beware Loose Gravel.
Beware Loose Gravel.
Yeah, and Loose Gravel Again, that kind of stuff, you know. I'm in C. You can't play in C with that thing on the second fret. You can't read it with a music stand there either. I heard today is Christmas times are coming. Christmas time to come in, Christmas time to come in, Christmas time to come in, and no, I'm going home. Snowflakes are falling, my old home's calling, all time to come in, Christmas time to come in. And yes, bells ringing, ringing, joy, joy, and sing, when it snows, I'll be going back to my country home. Funniest thing today, this is so indicative of how resourceful we are here in East Texas. I had to drive up to Rockwall this afternoon. I was driving back and I was coming through Wills Point, coming down Highway 80, and somewhere around Edgewood, there was a feed store. This guy pulls out of a feed store on a motorcycle.
Yeah. Carrying a 50-pound bale, a 50-pound bag of range cubes and a hay bale. And he handled it. I guess when you got a, when they need it, they need it, you know. Are y'all ready yet? On the motor? Well, yes, on the motorcycle. On the back of the motorcycle.
Tell us.
All right. I thought it was a funny story.
It will be
next time. Yeah.
I used to be a trumpet player a long time ago until I had an unfortunate accident in my two front teeth. And I couldn't put that horn mouthpiece right there anymore, so I switched over to guitar and never did. But then they came out a long time ago with this, I didn't quite understand this Christmas song, and it's All I Want for Christmas is My Two Front Teeth. We're gonna do it in the key of C.
There you go.
All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth, my two front teeth, my two front teeth. All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth, so I can wish you Merry Christmas. Gee, I can only have my two front teeth, and I could wish you Merry Christmas. It seems so long that I couldn't say, Sister Susie's sitting on the thistle. Every time I want you, with my two front teeth, my two front teeth. All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth, for I can only whistle.
Speed it all up a little bit.
I'm still figuring out that panel on the motorcycle with a
cow. You gotta play some on Phil first.
Cow coming out of a feed store.
B is in barn burner.
Did you say B is in barn?
B is in barn.
B is in barn. Oh, it's in barn. Well, that's different.
Thank you. Y'all play? Mr. Gordon, you want to play one here? There you go. There you go.
I think you're pretty hot, man. I'm up playing with you.
That's awesome.
We got a joyful trip back from college today. How are you?
Yeah.
company. Hey, to put the man on the player on the spot. You want to come in and pick for us first? Or the...
That's
all right.
That's all right.
Good. Let everybody get a chance to play.
Wasn't there somebody else out there with an instrument, too?
Yeah, they're tuning up.
Oh, so be in there a minute.
All right, girl, come on up and knock them out real quick. Bring Southern flavor.
go, guys.
Yeah.
Whiskey before breakfast.
The Celtic song.
B, E, Lord, I wish that there were words to say to express my love for you today, but no words of that can quite convey all the words inside my heart today. So I'll say it all in a simple phrase that's been said before in so many ways, for it best describes what I feel inside. Simply, I love you. I love you. I love you. I really love you. What more could I say than that I love you? I will try to live my life so that it says it too. I love you. I love you. I really love you. Words, if it's true, I know that I could never really say what I want to say, though I've painted all my life away. So I'm not back I started from, at a loss for words, I'm back to a simple phrase that will fill my days. Simply, I love you. What more could I say than that I really love you? And I will try to live my life so that it says it too. I love you. I love you. I really love you. I love you. I love you. I really love you. I will try to live my life so that it says it too. I love you. I love you. I really love you.
Years ago, Leonard Cohen wrote a song with a great melody, totally insane lyrics. I can't imagine a venue where the song would be appropriate to sing. But I love the melody. Last month at Tenney Chapel, we did a little Roger, my buddy Roger and I, hold your hand up, Roger, did a little veterans tribute. Found some veterans lyrics to the song. But after some effort, I found appropriate Christmas lyrics. Key of C, sort of. It's Leonard Cohen's Hallelujahs. Follow the major list. still every breath you drew was hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
It's already time.
Okay.
We're going to take our little 20-minute break. Meet and greet. Don't be a stranger. We'll be back in 20 minutes, and we'll start with Mr. Skelton right off the get-go. You going to start with him? All right.
Hospital, room 502, and it was the strangest thing. Mother wasn't doing very well at that time. She became septic, and we didn't know how she was going to do. And
she didn't expect me to come out of the hospital. That's how bad it was.
At one point, she said, if I don't come out of here, you get a lawyer. You hear? I went, yeah, yes, ma'am. Well, they were going to transfer her from the cardiac unit.
She's mad now because you got it.
Yeah. They were going to transfer her, and they told me to get her things together. So it was about 5 o'clock in the morning. And the door to the room was closed, and Mother, she and I had been talking, and I said, they're going to come get you, so I'm all cleaned up. Let me get the suitcase, get everything ready, so when the new shift comes on for the morning, we'll be able to move over to the other part of the hospital. They've done all they could do in the cardiac area. So she was laying there on the bed, and as I said, we've just been talking. She wasn't asleep, and I was putting things in the suitcase and zipping it and everything, had my back to her. And in a few moments, she said, thank you, ma'am, for your prayers. Mm-hmm. And I turned around and I said, who are you talking to? She said, that lady that just came in and prayed for me. I said, ooh, I get chills thinking about it. I said, Mother, nobody came in this room. The door did not open where I would have seen it because of the reflection on the glass. If y'all have ever been up there, it's a night outside and it's like a mirror. And I said, I didn't see anybody. And I got real quiet, and I said, well, what did she look like? And she said, she was as clear as, she got mad at me. She said, now, I know I saw somebody. She was as clear as you are right here. She said, she prayed for me. She took both of my hands, and I'll let her finish the rest, because I forget, she can describe her.
They messed up my vein, and I have permanent vein damage. So it was several days that I couldn't even bend my arm. Shirley came to visit. She saw it. And I couldn't even move my arm. And when this lady appeared, I was laying there with my arm this way, blocking out the light from the nursing station. And she took both hands and prayed for me. I didn't hear a word she said, but I could see her mouth moving. And as Delene said, when she got through, she turned to go toward the door, but she never got to the door. She disappeared. And Delene said, and when Delene and I were discussing it, and we even discussed it with the doctor and one of the sisters, and they said, this is not the first time this has happened. And anyway, she said that she wasn't here. I described her dress, how her hair was fixed, everything. And when we mentioned it to the doctor said, this is not the first incident we've had like this. He says, we've had lots of incidents. So whether it was an angel or not, I believe in angels and miracles myself. I don't know whether anybody else. That was just as real to me as me talking to you. And it's burned in my brain, and it'll be there till the day I die. And after she prayed for me, I appreciate the prayers of everybody that prayed for me, because prayers don't go unanswered. It might be no right now, but eventually you'll know what the answer is. But after this lady appeared and prayed for me, I could move my arm. But I wound up in the hospital, which was not even related to the heart problem, from the 16th of August to the 17th of November. And that was the 17th of September. And the doctor said I had today he gave me a good report. He says it's going to be a long, slow haul, but you will be getting better. We changed doctors because the doctor that we had when I had the heart attack, she said, go home and make your peace with God, because you're not going to get any better. And then I looked at Delene, and Delene looked at me. We come home, and we called the cardiologist, and he said, no, your mother's got many years in front of her yet. So that made me feel better. And we eventually changed doctors, and since then, I mean, they've been right on top of everything that's happened to me. And today he said, it's going to be a slow process, because we don't want to affect your kidneys anymore, because what they had to do threw me into kidney failure, and I one point lower, and I wound up on dialysis, but God undertook. He's the great physician. Yeah. So I intend to cook a lot more beef. Yeah.
get ready to rock.
Thank God, good.
Yes.
That's not very good grammar, but I'm telling you, he is good.
Come join in. Really,
you don't need to talk about it.
Yeah, I know. And I'm we all know how good Eugene is on that field. We all know that, and it's greatly appreciated. But I want to include these two young ladies because I want to hear them play those fiddles. Okay?
We're
gonna and that band's player. I want both y'all. If y'all, this is a good song for both y'all. We're proud to have y'all here. We hope we get to have y'all come back. So I'm going to do something kind of simple so everybody's included and nobody's going to struggle with this song. It's going to be a good song. This is a wound I can't erase. It's in D. Have you found I'm we don't like to admit this, but we're a dying breed. So y'all come on back, okay? We want to keep this going.
I can leave this down to the road.
That's what I'm saying.
I didn't realize when we picked out this novelty t-shirt idea, this loose gravel, our voice would be so gravelly. But whatever's going around, and I hope you don't get it, it takes about a month to get over, and I'm on week six. Of it.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. But I coughed so hard 2 weeks ago, or a week and a half ago, I pulled everything. You ever cough so hard it feel like you broke a rib? Well, it does. So if I go like that, it's not the song. It's because I turned wrong. This being the holiday season, families being the second most important thing of the Christmas season, first is recognition of our Savior's birth.
Amen.
And I'll tell you, I fought tooth and nail when my wife said we're going to go with the church group to the Holy Lands this year. I fought tooth and nail because I'm a tightwad from the word teeth. I redefined the word tightwad. Now, when she convinced me that we could go for $15, I was on board. And she knows my threshold of fiscal pain is $15. I don't know what she spent, but I only spent $15 the long way over.
That's true.
It's true. It's true. So, but we had the opportunity to stand there in Bethlehem and look across the valley over into Jerusalem. It was a beautiful experience, and it didn't seem as phenomenal to me in February as it is now, because I'm coming into Christmas season. In my mind, I'm still seeing
Midland, Texas.
Huh?
Oh, West Texas, yeah.
It don't look like that. No, the mustard flowers were blue everywhere, like a carpet of yellow. It's wonder it didn't give you hay fever. But yeah, it was beautiful. Well, this being, family being so important, I wanted to do a family-oriented song, too. And this is it. I'm sorry, wrong key.
What key you in?
Well, I was going to be in C, but I started in A, and that was wrong. No, A's right. A's right. I was looking one place and calling another place.
A? It don't matter what you play, which hand you need.
Thank you.
dark Sunday bed. But I know darn well when the night time comes, I was heading for the foot of the bed. They say some folks don't know what it is, that's what they all go to the place. The rest of the cover on a winter night, there's a big foot sitting in your face. Or a cold toenail scratching your back and a push push from your head. I'll tell the world you ain't lost a thing, never sleeping at the foot of the bed.
Well, I went to see Robert Earl King. That was a long time ago. Last time I went to see him, we sat there waiting on him for about 3 hours. He wouldn't get out of his bus. So I never did go back to see Robert Earl King, and he got to be a big star, but I kind of like one of his Christmas songs. And it's in the key of G. It's a four-chord change, goes to an E minor, a four-chord change song. So it's called Merry Christmas to the Family. Oh. My mom got drunk, my dad got drunk at a Christmas party. We were drinking champagne pumps and a wedding gown. Your sister brought a new boyfriend. He was amazing. Didn't know what to think of him, so he said, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad. Brother Kim brought his kids with him. First brother, first wife, Lynn. And the two identical twins from the second wife, Mary and Neil. Of course, he brought his first wife, Kate. Talked all about AA. Chain smoked my stereo blade. Noel, Noel, first Noel. Alright, here we go, the bridge. Called the turkey, turn the ball game on. Make Bloody Marys, cause we all want one. Send somebody to the big bag store. We need a zap and a kitchen cord. Okay. bloody berries, we all want one. Send somebody to the top and go. I need a friend and a can of fake soap. Bag of lemons and some prime price. A box of cigarettes, Marlboro Lights.
Thank you. if I never see you no more. God bless you everywhere you go.
Jesus.
everything to me. Yes, he's all the world to me. There are footprints in the sand along the shores of Galilee, where thousands came to hear and came to see him. There he spake of love and kindness. Yes, he brought a better way. And as he spake, they turned and whispered and say, Jesus, Jesus, he is the Son of God. Jesus, Jesus, the precious Son of God. Sweetest rose of Sharon has come. God turned black as they nailed him to a tree. He died there for every man and every country. But the price he paid and the blood he shed is still changing life today. And with joy and praise you can still hear people say, oh Jesus, Jesus, the Son of God. Jesus, Jesus, the precious Son of God. Sweetest rose of Sharon has come to set us free. Jesus, Jesus, he's everything to me.
Anybody in the room ever belong to a 12-step self-help group like AA? Or it's okay, you can admit it.
You're my friend.
So, those of you that have know that the first step is to admit your problems.
What, the copy or the...
So I'm Larry Gamble. My problem is I don't do bluegrass. At least not yet. I came close one time. I thought I'd accidentally learned one, but Eugene and Gordon looked at the music and they'd never heard it. So in a time or two I have deviated a little bit. Played some odd stuff. This isn't odd.
Deviate.
Steve's going to help me a little bit.
We have practiced this song so many times. I think, what, four? This song's actually a D. It starts in E minor.
Starts with a D minor, but it's just D's and C's and D's and E minors. My old friend, I've come to talk with you again. The wind's softly creeping, and it seems while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my
well, thank you, put some wood in there.
We're in the home stretch now.
Lower that down a little bit.
All right, let's do some country. What do you think?
Country.
Yeah. Well, all right, maybe it's rock. I don't know. You know, the Beatles did it. So is it rock or is it country? All right, we'll just find out. N G. Well, there. Gonna put me in the mood. They're gonna make a big star out of me. Biggest little ever to get the big crowd. And all I gotta do is act mad at me. Well, I bet you I'm gonna be a big star.
Yeah.
Well, well, well. The nights are growing short.
Are you going to draw for this?
Damn, I forgot all about that.
My wife believes in drinking pickle juice when your throat gets like this. Mm. I know they listen to it, but not when it comes to pickle juice.
Cornbread.
Or cornbread.
Cornbread and pickle juice, too.
Hey, let's try.
Large print hickle.
Yeah. You mean that one? Yes, I am. But I've got it in B flat. I don't know if B flat works for December.
Just B flat. Go ahead and put it in B flat.
Just go fishing, so I headed for the lake. Thought I'd probably spend the day. I was driving through the small town when I started feeling hungry. Pulled over in the gravel next to this little cafe. It didn't seem all that different from 100 other places, but the coffee sure smelled good, so I pulled up a chair. Went in, walked 10 or 15 men and headed for the back. May that seem peculiar, but I was trying not to stare. And they sang Amazing Grace. They sang just as I am. And they sang from the heart in a well-worn copy of the Lord's edition of the Heavenly Highway. With my coffee cup in hand, push my chair a little closer. I don't even want to miss a single word they had to say. And I completely forgot about that boat out on the trail. I guess the lake will have to wait for another day. Hang on a minute. I skipped the rail. When the waitress took my order, she could see I had a question. Got the men around the table in the little room next door. She said they were just some locals who came every Monday morning to study from the Bible and sing and praise the Lord. With my coffee cup in hand, pushed my chair a little closer. I didn't wish to miss a word they had to say. Thank you.
in the spirit with a song up in my hand. Singing songs, praise, joy, life everlasting. Praying and praising the Lord, lead the band. And we sang Amazing Grace. We sang just as I am. And we sang from the heart as a well-worn copy of the Lord's tradition on the heavenly highway. And we would sing Amazing Grace. We would sing just as I am. We would sing from the heart and a well-worn copy of the Lord's tradition on the heavenly highway.
We used to do our send-off about this time of night. We used to do a triplet. Gordon will finish us off with Amazing Grace there at the end. I'm going to go to B. We're going to do Thanks to the Sinuses. Yeah. B, we're going to go do B. We're going to do Hallelujah and Radio.
B.
Hallelujah, I'm ready to go. In the darkness of my
20. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.